Sleeping series part two. In part two, we're going to see the full cycle of sleeping. So that means we go through five different stages. And by understanding that information on how it works, you may unconsciously go through every part easily. So that means that if you are aware that this is what you're supposed to do, there are chances that unconsciously you're going to be better at transitioning into all these cycles just by understanding how it works. Not that you'll, in the middle of the night, be like, okay, now I'm moving into phase three. You won't be aware of this. You'll be sleeping. But just knowing the cycle will actually help give you a better sleep. So in stage one, you are falling asleep. So stage one is the interim section between consciousness and unconsciousness, so becoming asleep. So your eyes are closing and it only lasts for 1 to 5 minutes. So that first stage is from awake to sleeping, really. And some people are already saying, I object. I spend a lot more time than 5 minutes in here. That's why you're watching that series, so that you can figure out how to get a better sleep. For some people, it's how to stay asleep. They fall asleep very fast, but we'll cover that too. So just know that stage number one is that moment when you are actually falling asleep. Stage number two, it's the light sleep. So light sleep, your heart rate slows down. It's a period of sleep before entering the deep sleep, okay? So there's two more steps before you enter deep sleep. So this is stage two. Your heart rate slows down, breathing slows down, your muscle relax, you drop your body temperature a little bit, and then the eye movement stop as well. So the brainwave activity is marked as short, quick electrical activity. So it's like twitching. So you may be aware that, or some other people may have told you, like my husband tells me that I twitch at night. So then he knows that I'm in stage two. So I'm in light sleep when I'm twitching. So this part lasts between 10 and 25 minutes, depending on every different person and depending on every cycle, because we go through a lot more than one cycle during the night. So each cycle will be different as well. So when I say between 10 and 25 minutes, maybe the first time you might spend more time in the light sleep before getting into the deeper one, and then that may decrease as you are going through the second cycle, the third cycle, the fourth cycle of the night. Stage three is the delta stage. So they call it a delta stage because of the brain activity during this period is identifiable like a pattern of delta waves. So it's very similar to the short wave sleep. So they call that the delta sleep for that reason, because that's what's happening in the brain. So the muscle, the pulses, the breathing, everything decreases in stage three, and the body relaxes even further. And the brain activity during this period, like I said, is short wave. So it's not the twitching anymore. So now we're into the delta wave, and it's the short wave sleep, and that lasts for about 20 to 40 minutes again. Then we get into deep sleep. So that's when your body temperature drops and your blood flow drops as well. So for that reason, if the blood flow drops, then your body temperature will get colder as well. So sometimes during the night when you're cold, that's because you are in deep sleep, because you're needed to cuddle like these guys. And that's when you want to have maybe more blankets or deeper duvet or whatever. During that stage, your brain produces longer delta waves, okay? Now it's really hard for you to wake somebody up during that stage. So during deep sleep, we're not paying attention at all to the outside world. And even if we are very, very light during that sleep, the body, the brain is really into deep sleep, so we can't really wake somebody up. It's harder to wake somebody up during that time. And that's when you start your ability to form memories from all the the actions that have been happening during the day, that's when we start forming memories. Now, there are a lot of experts that are still trying to figure out exactly what the deep sleep part is good for, because the most popular one, the one that we are aiming to achieve, is that stage number 5, that REM sleep. The REM sleep, R-E-M, stands for rapid eye movement. So that's the moment where our eyes will start moving really fast. Let's understand that it's a cycle. So if we go into from light sleep to delta sleep to deep sleep, somehow we have to kind of reawaken ourselves to go back to light sleep and back to deep sleep and reawaken ourselves. So the REM sleep is that super productive time, really, that is studied a lot by neuroscientists, because it is believed that REM sleep plays a vital role in the ability to learn and to remember, since it's during the REM time that the brain processes, consolidate, store information all into the long-term memory. So it takes all the stuff that has been happening, and then that's when we start storing it. So that means that it's a very active moment where the brain is busy doing all this with our memory. Our eyes are moving faster, and it takes about 90 minutes to get into the REM sleep. So all the other phases are dedicated to lead you to the super amazing REM sleep. But that REM sleep only lasts for about 10 minutes. We don't spend a lot of time there. And because we will do many cycles, we might stay longer on the second cycle and longer on the third cycle and longer on the fourth cycle. So ideally, we want all these add up, because you could stay as long as 1 hour in REM. In the last cycles of the night, ideally you would like to reach about a 90 minute period in that REM time, counting every single cycle. So on average, you'll go through 3 to 5 cycles per night, and each episode of REM is going to get longer as the night progresses. Now for healthy adults, spending 20 to 25% of your time asleep in the REM stage is a good goal. So if you get 7 to 8 hours of sleep, that would be about 90 minutes. Children and adults would spend 50% of their total sleep in stage 2 in that light sleep, and about 20% in REM, and then the remaining 30% is split between the others. While infants, babies, by contrast, spend about half of their sleep time in REM. So that's interesting how you can see, sometimes babies, you can see their eyes moving rapidly because they spend a lot more time in REM. So think about your cycles. Know that, let's say that it does take you half an hour to go to sleep. Then if you do 4 full cycles, then that would be 6 hours for that, plus your half hour to actually fall asleep. So then you would think that a night for you is like 6.5 hours. If you do 5 cycle, you would have 7.5 hour plus this half hour falling asleep. So you plan 8 hours in bed. If you want an extra cycle, you would plan for 9 hours plus this half hour falling asleep if you need that. So try to realize how much time it takes you for that phase 1. It should be between 1 and 5 minutes, but if it's not, try to remember that it's ideal to complete the full cycle before you awaken, right? Because otherwise, I will cover that in that next part. In part 3, we will talk about the importance of finishing a cycle before you get up. So how to set up your alarm. We're going to be talking about snoozing, right? We're going to be talking about napping. We're going to be talking about dreams as well. So I will see you next time in part number 3 in the sleep series.